Hello students, welcome to the class. So this class topic is sign convention rules of spherical mirrors. So here, what is meant by sign convention? So here, convey means just you are applying a symbol for the parameter. So conveying the symbol, sign, plus or minus. So here, why we need to apply the sign for the parameters? So here you have a different formulas here. That is a relation between the focal length and radius of curvature f equal to r by 2, and mirrors formula 1 by f equal to 1 by v minus 1 by v plus 1 by u, and the magnification formula m equal to minus v by u or m equal to hi by h naught. So here, for any mirror, any situation, you need to use this generalized formulas. So here, with the symbols, we can generalize these formulas for any situation. So for that, we need to apply the sign for the parameter here. So it will become universal. That formula become universal with this conveying of sign. So what they are? So here, generally, we have three sign convention rules here. While measuring the different parameters related to the spherical mirrors, maybe concave mirror or the convex mirror. So what are the parameters? They are here: measuring the focal length, measuring the radius of curvature, measuring object distance, image distance, height of the object, and height of the image. So these are the parameters we are measuring while explaining the characteristics of image in the ray diagrams or maybe while solving the problems. So here, just look at on the screen here, I am showing the parameters related to the situations of a concave mirror or a convex mirror, anything. So one of the example I will take here. So for example, here I consider an example when an object is placed beyond the center of curvature in front of a concave mirror. So here, object always we are placing above the principal axis. According to the situation, the image may be virtual or real. So here, whatever it may be. So here, commonly, I will give you one logic at the end of this video also. So here, just object is placed beyond the center of curvature above the principal axis. So here, what are the rules how to use for this situation? So the first rule is all the distances should be measured from the pole of the mirror. So here, why we need to measure this like this? So here, a fixed distance is there between a mirror and to the object, or mirror to the focus, or mirror to the radius of a curvature. So here, for measuring any distance, we have to fix our position first, right? So that distance between two fixed points you are expressing as that focus to the pole distance is called here focal length, and a pole to the center of curvature is called here radius of curvature, and pole to the object here called as object distance, and pole to the image is called here image distance. So here, measure all these distances from the pole only. Any distance you are measuring, just you have to start from the pole. Suppose here you are measuring the object distance. So you are placed the object here beyond the center of curvature. So start from the pole and place your scale from pole to the object distance u. Then express this distance. Then here we have to apply the sign. So how to apply this sign for the distances? So here, whatever it may be that distance you are measuring, so I am saying the second rule here, that distance will be assigned with a sign depending on the direction it is opposite to the instant light ray or along the instant light ray direction. So here, if you are measuring the distance in the direction of instant light ray, it is taken as a positive distance or positive value. If that distance is measured in the opposite direction of instant lighter direction, then it is taken as a negative. So here object distance from pole to the object, so always that instant light rays directed towards a mirror. Here pole to the object, here you are moving against, opposite in the direction of instant light ray. So here the object distance is given as a negative. So image, so for this situation image will be obtained between the focus and the center of curvature. So here it is also measured opposite in the direction of light ray, so instant light ray. So that is also expressed as negative. So image distance V also negative here. Then when the V will become positive here, if that is obtained on the surface, that means virtual image. If the virtual image is obtained by the spherical mirror, it may be convex or concave, then it is taken as a positive. That means image will be obtained behind the mirror. So here look at that formation of image by a concave mirror when the object is placed between pole and the focus. So in this situation you will get a virtual image. So for this image distance will be
positive.
So there is any simple logic for this, sir? Yes, definitely we have a simple logic. So simple logic is what? Always the light rays, instant light rays directed towards a mirror. So always you are placing the object in front of the mirror. So whatever it may be, the parameter you measured in front of the mirror is taken as negative. If that parameters are measured behind the mirror, it is taken as positive. So the parameters like focal length, radius of curvature, object distance, always a negative for a concave mirror because they are located in front of the mirror. If you measure these parameters like focal length, radius of curvature and image distance, always positive for a convex mirror, because image always given by a convex mirror is virtual, diminished and erect behind the mirror. So it is always positive for convex mirror. But here, what about the object distance for convex mirror? Object distance always negative for any mirror because we are placing the object in front of the mirror. So it is measured from the pole towards the object against to the instant light ray direction. Remember, instant light ray always directed to the mirror surface. Then what about the other parameters like object height and image height? So object always measured above the principal axis. If any measurement taken above the principal axis, it is given as positive. If that measured image height below the principal axis, it is given as negative. So for a inverted image, image height always negative. For object height, for any mirror, irrespective to the mirror, object height always positive because the condition is object always placed above the principal axis. Then image, for a real image, image height is negative. For a virtual image, that means erect image, it is positive. So these are the sign convention rules. So like this, we are applying the sign convention rules for the spherical mirrors. So thank you. We will meet with another class.